गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर फ्रॉम इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज चैलेंज ऑफ नेशन बिल्डिंग. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस देयर वर थ्री इम्पॉर्टेंट चैलेंजेस, राइट. सो दोज वर वन चैलेंज वॉज टू एस्टैब्लिश डेमोक्रेसी, अ सक्सेसफुल डेमोक्रेसी, एंड अनदर वन टू शेप अ नेशन वेयर अ डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ पीपल diversity of people belongs to different religion, culture and everything lives in a one single country. So that is to shape a nation. And the third one is for the development and well-being of the whole society. So these were the three challenges, and in this chapter we will discuss about the first challenges, that is to shape a nation. So what are the problems that India has faced in the shaping of the nation? We will start this one. So the first and the foremost challenge at that time, or we can say a major problem during that period, was the partition. All of us have already known about partition. We have seen so many movies, watched videos and everything, right? We have heard and we have learned also about the partition in India. When the British India as a whole has been divided into two countries, that is India and Pakistan, a Hindu country and a Muslim country. So that was called two nation theory. So in that two nation theory, if sometimes the question comes to what is two nation theory, you have to write Hindu India and Muslim Pakistan. So that was a two nation theory. On 14th and 15th August 1947, no one but two nation came into existence, India and Pakistan. So that was the result of partition. So people have to move from one country to another, right, wherever they belongs, the majority of the religion. So the government has decided how can we partition India, how can we partition the whole country. So at that time everyone thought that it's better to partition the country on the issue of religion. So whichever, there were only two majority of religion was there, one is Muslim and the Hindus. So they have decided that Muslim majority will reside in one country and Hindu majority will reside in another country. So that's how the partition happened. Muslim went to Pakistan and the Hindus came to India. So that was a two nation theory. And there were so many people, so many leaders who were against this partition, who has opposed this partition. Even the Congress government has opposed this partition. They did not wanted the partition. But at that time, the situation was like that. No one can stop this partition. So everyone has to go through the partition. Everyone has to participate in that partition. No one can stop that partition. But though they are against this, even the Muslim League, they were against this. The Congress government, one of our the most important, the founder member of the government, the Congress party, they were also against this partition. But no one can stop this partition. So after when there was a partition, when the country was divided into two parts, at that time Hindus came to India and Muslims went to Pakistan. Now the process, how did this partition happen? What were the process they have used during the partition? So it was decided that what was still then known as India would be divided into two countries, India and Pakistan. Such a division was not only very painful but also very difficult to decide and to implement. It was decided to follow the principle of religious majority. This basically means that areas where the Muslims were in majority would make up the territory of Pakistan. The rest was to stay with India. Like I said, the partition has been decided on the basis of majority, religious majority. So people from Muslim community went to Pakistan. But it's not simple. This is like we are reading. right? Muslim majority went to Pakistan and Hindu majority came to India. So whenever we are saying this, this is so easy, this seems so easy, right? But this was not an easy task. This was very, very difficult, a very, very painful. Lots and lots of people died during that partition. Lots and lots of people became homeless during that partition. Okay, so there were two areas of concentration, one in the west and one in the east. There was no way these two parts could be joined. So it was decided that the new country, Pakistan, will comprise two territories, West and East Pakistan, separated by a long expanse of Indian territory. So in Pakistan also there are two parts, East and the West. But we cannot divide Pakistan. They cannot divide Pakistan into two parts. So they have decided that Pakistan will have two sides, East and West, and both will have Muslim majority. And that has been divided, that has been separated by a Indian territory. Okay, so secondly, not all Muslim majority areas wanted to be in Pakistan. Similar was the case. Not every Muslim wanted to go to Pakistan, and not every Indian, every Hindu wanted to come to India. People were also, they also have their own opinion, they also have their own belief. They did not wanted to go to Pakistan, right? People have, when they came, when they born in one particular country, when they have a family in that particular country, they raise their children, their work is there, everything belongs to one particular country. But because of their religion only, if they have to leave everything behind, then that was not easy for the common people. So there were many, many Muslim people who did not wanted to go to Pakistan. Similarly, in India also, Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, the undisputed leader of Northwest Frontier Province, also known as Frontier Gandhi, was staunchly opposed to the two-nation theory. Even the Northwest Frontier Province, the Frontier Gandhi, Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, he also opposed this two-nation theory. But he cannot do anything. Eventually his voice was simply ignored and was made to merge with Pakistan. He also have to merge with Pakistan. He also have to belong to Pakistan, whether he belongs willingly or not. He has to. He does not have any other choices. So there were so many people, whether the common people or the people who are well-known people like the Frontier Gandhi. He was very well-known at that time. He strongly opposed this two-nation theory, but he did not have any choice. He has to merge with Pakistan. So that was, we can say that partition was... basically, the partition, this partition has damaged the life of the common people, the life of the poor people, because of from that time onwards, Hindus and Muslims has been divided into two parts. The country itself has been divided into two countries. The two-nation theory has been started in India and Pakistan. But the people, what about the people like we? I am Indian, I am Hindu, but even I like Muslim peoples, right? Like you, some of them are Muslims, but it's not that you are Muslim, you belong to Pakistan, you have to go to Pakistan. We cannot say that now. But during that period, when the partition was going on, everyone was bound to follow the rules at that time. So they have to leave their country and go to the place where their religious majority belongs. Though there were many leaders, many parties, they were opposing this two-nation theory. But no one has any choice but to partition. Okay. The third problem was that the two of the Muslim majority province, British India, Punjab and Bengal, had very large area where the non-Muslims were in majority. So in Punjab and Bengal, there are there are non-Muslim majority were in large in number, Punjab and Bengal. That is the third problem. Okay. Eventually, it was decided that these two provinces would be bifurcated according to the religious majority at the district or even lower level. This decision could not be made by the midnight of 14th to 15th August. So, the people of Bengal and Punjab, there are lots and majority of the people were non-Muslim, but that part belongs to the area of the Pakistan, the Muslim majority. So, this has not been decided about the Pakistan and about Punjab and Bengal. Okay, actually the when the speech was given by Jawaharlal Nehru, the tryst with destiny, in during that speech it has been decided that the partition will be there. Okay, but the people of Bengal and Punjab, they did not have any idea, because in that speech the Bengal and Punjab has not been mentioned by Jawaharlal Nehru. So the people of Bengal and Punjab, they did not have any idea where they belong. They were not forced to do anything, or they were not said to do anything. So they do not have any idea whether they have to go to Pakistan or they have to stay in India, because they were in large number of people were non-Muslim during that period. And it was the large number of people did not know on the day of independence whether they were in India or Pakistan. The partition of these two provinces caused the deepest trauma of partition. So it's not we cannot say that the partition was only of the country. The country was divided, but there was a partition of people also. People were also divided. So this was one of the trauma for the common people, for the people who has to leave everything from one place to another. So the problem of minorities during that period, who were in minorities, both the minorities lives in the border of India and Pakistan, and both were Hindus and Muslim. There were equal number of Hindus and equal number of Muslim minorities, and they were in the border of India and Pakistan. Now, who will decide on the fate of those minorities people? No one was there. They just have to travel from one place to another. Lakhs of Hindus and Sikhs in the areas. Everywhere, actually, violence was there. Because when they were traveling from one place to another, Hindus were attacking Muslims and Muslims were attacking Hindus. Because of you, we have to leave our land. This was the question they have raised. This was the issue they were feeling at that time. No one has planned this partition. But in order to have independence, partition was must during that period. And like I was said was the problem of minorities on both sides of the border. Lakhs of Hindus and Sikhs in the areas that were now in Pakistan, and an equally large number of Muslims on the Indian side of Punjab and Bengal found themselves trapped. They were trapped. They did not have any place to go. They were to discover that they were undesirable alien in their own home. As soon as it became clear that the country was going to partition, the minorities on both sides became easy target of attack. So the minorities, those people who lives in the border area, they have been attacked both by Hindus and by the Muslims. So partition was not an easy task. From one country to another country, one has to travel, one has to leave everything behind. So that was not an easy task. And it's not only about traveling, it's not only about leaving your place, but the violence was there. Attacking, quarreling, there were so people were terrified during that period. These small children were killed, they have to run. You must have seen one or two photographs, right? In this book also, seen page number 9, there is one photograph. People were look at the picture in that train, how many peoples are there. Okay, almost people were above that train, on the terrace of that train also. So they have to travel like that. Many were killed, many were violated at that time. Rules and regulations were not there during that time. Now the consequences, result. What was the result of the partition? Consequence: lakhs and lakhs of people died. Violence, everywhere violence were there. Women were abducted in their own area. Some of the women were killed, some were raped, and some of the women were forcefully they were forced into marriage, and some of the women they were forced to change their religion. Those who did not manage to cross the border found that they had no home. Many people have crossed the border. They went to the, like, the Muslim people, if they travel from India, they cross the border, they reached Pakistan, but they do not have any home. They do not have anything over there. They were homeless. People were in poverty at that time. Kidnapping, violence, murder, everything was there. This was the most terrified incident of the history of India. Everywhere you will find riots, Hindus and Muslim. Everything was divided. Everything was from a small place to the whole country has been divided. People were divided. Violent was there. And separation was very, very violent during that time. And writers and poets, filmmakers in India and Pakistan have expressed the ruthlessness of the killing and the suffering of the displacement and violation in their novels. You can read many novels, you can see movie also, or you can find in Google also, search once the partition of India. You will see the picture, the violent. We can say that it was the most pitified incident of India, the most terrified incident of India. We cannot imagine what happened if something like that happens today in our world. I don't think we will be able to face that situation in today. So imagine how the people, how the people of that particular time, they have imagined, they have really faced all those problems, the violence. Everywhere there was violence. So this was it. Shape of nation. Number one, the shaping of the nation. So the first challenge is to shape a nation. They started by partition. So partition was there. India and Pakistan were divided into two countries, and the partition was based on religious majority. So Muslim went to Pakistan and Hindus came to India. Like Bangladesh already have two sides, east and west. Pakistan has two sides, east and west. One became Bangladesh during 1970s, I guess. So initially there were two parts, and the Muslims were over there already, and Punjab and Bengal, they were non-Muslim majority, but they do not have any idea till the day of independence where they belong, where do you have to go, because the Punjab and Bengal were not mentioned in Jawaharlal Nehru's midnight speech. So they do not have any idea, and the minorities of the people who resides in the border, they have faced such an attack. People both the sides, from Hindus and the Muslim, they have attacked them. Okay, so and one more thing, violence, separation, and everything was there. But this partition has not been planned. This partition has not been planned by any of the drafting committee or any of the leader or any of the party. But this has happened. Suddenly, this has happened. Many leaders, many parties were against this. They were opposing this, like the Frontier Gandhi. He opposed this. Congress opposed this. Muslim League opposed this. But there was no one to stop this partition. Partition has happened, and the consequences was violence. Everywhere you will see only violence, murders, killings, women were abducted, people who managed to cross the borders, they become homeless. They did not find anything. They have to leave all whatever belongings they have to leave behind. So everything was very, very sorrowful. How the people of that particular time has managed this partition, how they have faced this partition, we cannot even say in words. So if you want to know more about partition, if you want to see the exact picture of partition, please Google it. You will find everything. Okay, till then, in our next class we will start integration of princely state. It's because we were studying to shape a nation. Okay, so integration of princely state we will do in our next class. Till then, take care and be safe, and please do read.